Hi, everybody. Keith Shaw here for IDG Enterprise. We are talking with Brandon Butler from Network World, live from the VMworld conference in San Francisco. Brandon, how you doing?
I'm good, Keith. How are you?
I'm very good. I'm back here in our little mini studio that we set up. Tell us what some of the themes are this year from VMworld.
Well, this is day two of VMworld here, and yesterday during the opening day kickoff, CEO Pat Gelsinger really had two messages for the audience. One was there's a whole theme here about no limits, and Gelsinger said that IT organizations really need to break down the barriers that are allowing them to get to this next evolution of IT, which involves cloud and mobile and software-defined data centers. And the other message that he had was that IT organizations and IT leaders should be brave in how they're going about doing this. And he said VMware is going to be brave in terms of launching new products and embracing these new technologies. So those were the two big themes out of VMware yesterday.
All right. What are you hearing in terms of their go-to-market strategy? I guess is there a new approach, or is there just something different from what we've heard in previous years?
Well, Pat Gelsinger came on as CEO of VMware about a year and a half ago, and when he did, he outlined a three-pronged strategy for their go-to-market, and it involves three things. One is what they call the software-defined data center. So the idea of this is that VMware has been really good at virtualizing the compute layer through its ESX hypervisor. Now it wants to do the same thing across the storage and network components. So they call that the software-defined data center. The other big focus they have is on cloud computing, and VMware says it's one of the few companies that can offer a integrated hybrid cloud approach that combines public cloud and private cloud resources. And then thirdly, their last piece of go-to-market strategy is around end-user computing, and this is basically about managing mobile devices that end-users have, delivering virtual desktops and virtual applications, and so those have been the three big things that they've been talking about here at VMworld.
All right, have you seen any new products either from VMware or some of the third-party partners? Anything really exciting out there?
Yeah, there's been a number of things that VMware has announced. One thing that I think caught some people, at least by surprise, was VMware announced some pretty heavy integrations with OpenStack, which is an open-source cloud management platform. I think a lot of people were not expecting that VMware would embrace OpenStack with or the way it did. So that's been interesting to watch. VMware also made some announcements around its public cloud, and so they said that they're going to be adding some new services and features like database as a service, new DevOps services for its public cloud. And so we think VMware is trying to really compete with some of the big behemoths of the cloud market like Amazon and Google in those announcements. VMware also announced a new hyper-converged infrastructure called Evo Rail. And finally, it updated a number of its products like vSphere and vCenter. So there's a lot of news going on here out at VMworld. And of course, the partners, they have over 250 partners at the expo floor here. And almost all of those partners have their own news that they're making as well. A lot of stuff around cloud, network virtualization. And that's a lot for the 22,000 people who are attending this VMworld show to consume. So it's busy out here in San Francisco.
Yeah, what's the mood on the floor like? Is there a lot of people excited about VMware, or is there a sense that maybe, you know, that this is just kind of a regular old year for them?
Well, I think that it's a mixed feeling out there. I think VMware is one of those companies that has a huge legacy install base, and a lot of their customers are looking to this new technology out there, like cloud and mobile computing, and they're really looking to VMware to see how VMware's go-to-market strategy fits in with their plans of trying to integrate in this new technology. But, you know, VMware isn't the only player in town here. You know, all the companies out there, Cisco and Red Hat and Amazon and Google, they're all trying to go after this market and help companies get into that next wave of IT. And VMware is certainly making its pitch this week that they want to be the vendor for customers to choose.
All right, how many more days of the show, and when are you coming back?
So the show actually officially goes through Thursday, but I'm going to be heading back tomorrow, Wednesday afternoon. Today was the last day of keynotes, I have a couple more meetings this afternoon with some vendors and analysts, some VMware folks, and the sessions continue through tomorrow, though. So a four-day conference for VMworld 2014.
All right, and all of our coverage is on networkworld.com. For more VMworld coverage, just click on some of the links in the stories and such. Thanks a lot, Brandon. We'll see you at the end of the week or next week.